the Atlanta girls we talk about all the time is like, yeah, Atlanta walks so Potomac could run. And it's, you know, I am proud to kind of be a product of what Atlanta has done for the Bravo sphere. And it means a lot to kind of walk in their footsteps and be in this what do I call it, a dysfunctional sisterhood. This is a dysfunctional sisterhood together.
Hi, Candiace. I'm good. How are you? I'm loving this deep space behind you. All the merch, all the posters.
Candy Space Deluxe. We are in space. Yes.
It's so good to see you as always. It's so funny. I feel like we were just talking.
I know, right? We were. Yes.
But they got you busy, I think, which is a good thing.
Right. Yes. You're getting the latest and the greatest.
Mm-hmm. And we got to talk a little bit last time about Ultimate Girls Trip, but now that I got to see these first three episodes, you were not wrong in terms of how entertaining this is.
Yes. It's hilarious, right? I was like up watching last night in the bed and Chris was asleep. And I was like covering my mouth, cracking up at just random things. Like Marisol is funny on accident. Like she doesn't even mean to be funny. Like her being like, yeah, bro, I just want a cocktail. I'm gonna have a cocky. I love her. Portia's hilarious. Like everybody was so funny.
It's so fun. And what were your, I guess, first impressions? I wanted to ask you specifically, were there some of these women who you had met? Because I know Bravo keeps you guys, you know, you guys do like Housewife to Housewife Instagram lives or BravoCon or Watch What Happens Live. Were there Housewives outside of Giselle, of course, who you had met before? And were they different filming the show?
So I had met Leah prior. And that was it. I didn't know any of the other women before this. And so Leah and I were cool. We had interacted on social media many times before, and I watched her on New York and I loved her on New York. So I was excited that she was going to be there. I watched Miami when they were on Bravo years ago, and I never understood why they got canceled. I thought they were really great and I loved their show. So I was excited to meet Marisol and Alexia. I loved Mama Elsa, as someone that has a dynamic mom myself. I was excited to meet Marisol and, you know, talk to her about her mom. Alexia had a lot of drama with her husbands and, like, you know, the tragic accident with her son and how she and her family bounced back from that. She just has been through so much. I was interested to like learn more about that. And then like Salt Lake, I had watched season one and part of season two. And I was just interested to see like how those girls were in person, because they seem to always be screaming at each other on the show. And they screamed in Thailand.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. That's what I think is so interesting too. And I'm sure now, like we talked about last time, those seasons between Miami, Salt Lake City, and your seasons had all just wrapped.
Yeah.
And then they took you guys on the show. And now that I feel like we've all seen these seasons, they weren't just any seasons. They were really intense for all the people involved who wound up going on this trip.
Yeah. I think it's, for me, I understood my drama with Giselle, but Whitney and Heather, I found myself like my eyes glazing over because they were just, it was so deep. And I always say when Mia and Jacqueline were fighting all season on our show, I would say, this is a domestic issue. This is not our business. They need to go to therapy. It's not our business. And a lot of Whitney and Heather stuff was domestic issues. This is not fixable or repairable in this short space of time. So let them go over there and hash it out in the corner. Like there was so much drama. Like we had a boat party that Alexia hosted. And I remember I was just sitting there like, what the hell is happening? Like who did what and whose names are not on the rolls and who's a bad Mormon and the book and like what is happening? It was a lot.
Yeah, y'all didn't step two feet on that boat. I don't even think you guys took off into the water before you pop it off.
It was going off, yes.
Absolutely. Now, I think it is interesting too, how it's fun with the Salt Lake City girls, for example, they're like the newest. Yeah. So it's fun to see. And then you guys, and then of course, Portia's been there for a long time and Leah's there for a while, but she wasn't filming then. So
right.
You have different styles of doing this.
Yeah.
So it's really cool to see.
Yeah. And it was interesting to kind of compare notes on like, well, how do you all film your seasons? And then just to see how everybody interacted. Like one big difference I noticed was on Potomac, we fight and we argue, but I'm gonna let Robin or Ashley say whatever BS foolishness she wants to say. You and I'm gonna let you get it out. And then I'm going to respond and I'm gonna cuss you out. But we let each other talk more.
Mm-hmm.
Miami, Salt Lake. Like my brain was going to fall out of my ears. Like it was so intense. Like, how do you all even hear? Who's editing this? Who, you have to turn this mic down so you can hear what she said and then wait for her to respond. It was really interesting to see like those subtle differences.
I was thinking the same thing because there are so many moments where, because Miami definitely is like that and Salt Lake City too, but there are moments with all you guys where the editors are doing such a good job because there's one conversation going on and other people fighting here.
On the shuttles, yes. Like the two in the front are talking and the two in the back are having, they're totally different. And then the two in the back would jump in on the front and then go back to their conversation. Yeah, it was a lot.
it certainly looked like it, but listen, it's great for us. I'm enjoying it.
Amazing.
Also, talk to me too about, you kind of hinted at it a little bit, but it must be nice to get rid of that fourth wall. Like, what are the big differences filming a show like this where, you know, you can straight up say like, this is rubbing the wall, or like, we're shooting, or when are we, whatever, as opposed to the things you do in the normal Housewives show?
For me, it's like, I was able to break free from the chains of that wall. The wall was the chains and I was breaking free. On our cast, on Potomac, we actually, some of us break fourth wall a lot. Like I was always looking into the camera and being like, I'm not talking to this hoe, or whatever I would say.
Right. Right.
It just so happened that this season 7, they used it. And Karen breaks fourth wall all the time. Mia was doing it a little bit. So being on a show where it's almost encouraged to talk about the BTS of it all is, it's like it feels freeing and like relieving that we can discuss the things that, you know, in seasons 1 and 2 of like OC, it was like sacrilegious, like you don't even mention Bravo. Mm-hmm. And then when you think about like, Denise Richards, when she tried to do that Bravo, Bravo, effing Bravo thing, because back in the day, yeah, that used to be a thing. But now it's like, you know, the network has had to evolve with the times. And it's one of the reasons I think that these shows have been so successful for so long, because, you know, for the most part, Bravo has done a really good job of like keeping up with what the fans want to see. And they want to see the real of reality.
Right.
And part of that is talking about, you know, the camera and what the producer said to me and all of that.
Yeah. And the fan response, like, I feel like a lot of times too, there's so much pressure, I'm sure, when you're filming your normal show, right? Mm-hmm. You're like, I'm stressed out because I know in 5 or 6 months, this is about to be on the air. Everyone's going to be tweeting about it or whatever. You can't really express it.
Yes, right. You have to just sit quietly and not say anything and pretend like your life is fine, but inside you're screaming.
Right, absolutely. Yeah. And I think I have time for one more question. So for this experience on all, let's say Wendy or Mia, Robin, anyone in your cast gets the opportunity to do this. Like, what is some advice you would give them? And what are like some big differences that you would kind of tell them, you know?
I would say, you know, just go in with an open mind and be ready for anything, because you have no idea like where you're going, who's gonna be there, what they're gonna be like. You know, are they like strategizing to, you know, ask you crazy questions? Be ready for that. And and just like represent us well. Like, I think we tried to represent our respective franchises well, and we had a lot of pride in our individual franchises. And there was one moment where there was like a little fight because the Miami girls were like, "Where we are the oldest and we're the real OGs," and then everybody was like, "Excuse me, y'all were off the air for 8 years, you ain't nothing." So there's a lot of pride there. So I would encourage them to go with that same pride and just be ready for anything.
Oh my gosh. And that moment too, where you were like, when you acknowledged being the second all black cast, and then you also did give your flowers to Portia and being like,
"Yes,
Atlanta, of course." Like, it was so nice to see those moments.
Yeah. That, I mean, it's something that I think a lot of our cast and the Atlanta girls, we talk about all the time, is like, yeah, Atlanta walked so Potomac could run. And it's, you know, I am proud to kind of be a product of what Atlanta has done for the Bravo sphere. And it means a lot to kind of walk in their footsteps and be in this what do I call it, a dysfunctional sisterhood. This is a dysfunctional sisterhood together.
Absolutely. It definitely is. Listen, I am like already waiting for those next however many episodes. I'm like, it's not even out yet. So I'm excited.
Yeah.
Yes. Always good to talk to you. Good to see you.
Good to talk to you too. It's good to see you.